Hello, Strasbourg, and others watching this daily devotion today. It is Thursday, June 11th, 2020. We are continuing our exploration of the different spiritual disciplines that have emerged out of the Christian tradition over the last 2,000 years. And we began yesterday with a new one called Lectio Divina, and which basically means spiritual reading of Scripture. Now, this practice was created in the 4th century by St. Gregory of Nyssa, and then Benedict of Nursia, I don't know how you say it, made it famous in the Benedictine order of monks. And the practice involves reading Scripture not to get to the beginning and the end, like you may have read the Bible, you know, you're taught to read books from the beginning and end and kind of figure out the purpose. But for the spiritual practice is to let the Scripture rest upon your heart and to hear what God is saying to you. Now, the way that Benedict described how we should do it is that you read the Scripture 4 times, and it could take up to half an hour for you to reflect and think and write and understand where God is leading you, maybe even longer if you're somebody who needs to contemplate on the Scripture even further. So the practice that we are doing this week is going to be just taking one scripture, and that is Colossians chapter 3, verses 1 through 3, and we began this yesterday. And again, I want you to prepare your heart for this. Grab a piece of paper, back of an envelope. If you're like me, you always get these envelopes of bills and everything, and I just keep the envelopes of scrap paper. Grab a pen and listen to these words as I read them out to you. And if there is a word that is just all of a sudden your mind can't stop thinking about it, write it down. And then allow that word or that phrase to open up a conversation with God as you contemplate this. So the way we're gonna do this is I'm gonna read the scripture through 4 different times. And what I would like you to do is then pause this video and set a timer on your phone or set a timer on your microwave, wherever you are, for 5 minutes or 10 minutes. And I want you to reflect on the scripture and say, God, what are you trying to tell me through these words? And you could journal, you could write poetry, you could just be in prayer, you could repeat the words over and over again. But do it in a way that you are listening to God. And so it goes without saying that I hope you can find a quiet place somewhere in your house. Maybe you're surrounded by kids or you're surrounded by all the other stuff. Turn off the TV, turn off the radio, shut the door, go to the basement, whatever you need to do to find a quiet place. So let me read this scripture for you. It is Colossians chapter 3, verses 1 through 3. So, if you have been raised with Christ, seek the things that are above, where Christ is, seated at the right hand of God. Set your minds on things that are above, not on things that are on earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. So if you've been raised with Christ, seek the things that are above, where Christ is, seated at the right hand of God. Set your minds on things that are above, not on things that are on earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. So, if you have been raised with Christ, seek the things that are above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Set your minds on things that are above, not on things that are on earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. So if you have been raised with Christ, seek the things that are above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Set your minds on things that are above, not on things that are on earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. I hope that you had a chance to pause this video and spend a little time, maybe 5 or 10 minutes, reflecting on our words from Colossians chapter 3. I like the idea of Lectio Divina. It is a great practice to get our spirits are ready to hear the Word of God as it continues to speak to us throughout the generations. And so with that in mind, I would like now for us to continue in a word of prayer for our world and for you. Loving God, we thank you for this day. We thank you for those who are watching this devotional video, who have committed to becoming better at their spiritual lives and learning some new practices that will deepen their relationship to you. Lord, we ask that as we continue to go through this coronavirus, as we continue to hear the news reports that are full of protest and violence and just the bad news of ongoing trends of health, that you just take away our fear and anxiety and give us your peace. Lord, let our hearts not be just focused on the things of this world, but Lord, let us remember what you're calling us to do and be and to think about, these things that are from above that Paul so eloquently mentions. Lord, continue to be in our hearts as we develop relationships with others or as we strengthen the relationships we already have. Lord, be with us in our loneliness as some of us are separated from loved ones and friends. Lord, be with those who hunger and thirst, who are ill, who are grieving. And Lord, inspire us to be more and to be better than we are today. We pray all this in your name as we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. I'm going to share with you a song today called Thy Word. It was written by Michael W. Smith back in the early 1980s, sung by Amy Grant. Something we have in our hymnal, and it's one of my favorites because it reminds me of the importance of Scripture and why Scripture continues to speak to us now. So I hope you enjoy this song. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. When I feel afraid and think I've lost my way, still you're there right beside me. Nothing will I fear as long as you are near. Please be near me to the end. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. I will not forget your love for me, and yet my heart forever is wandering. Jesus, be my guide and hold me to your side. I will love you to the end. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. And a light unto my path. Amen. And I'll see you tomorrow. God bless you.